At this point, we can write programs that store and manipulate single numbers and words. These programs are run by stepping through the main program one instruction at a time. That's okay, but there are some limitations. We don't yet have the power to sometimes do one thing and other times do something else. And while we have the power to do things that are repetitive, the code would be very, very long, and ultimately that becomes hard to read. So we need to learn some more sophisticated control structures. In order to do that, you need to discover a new type of data. This data is called Boolean data, and it's sort of interesting because it has only two values. One is true and the other is false. Notice that there are no quotes around true and false. These aren't strings, it's a different data type. Boolean data is created mostly by operators like greater than or less than, greater than or equal to, equal and not equal. Now, equal is a little bit different in Java than it is in math. It's two equal signs put together. And not equal is an exclamation point followed by an equal sign. So for example, 2 less than 3 has the value true, because 2 in fact is less than 3. 5 equals equals 10 is false, because 5 and 10 are not the same value. 5 exclamation point equals 10, however, is true, because 5 and 10 aren't the same. Conditional statements are what allows Java to sometimes do one thing and sometimes do something else. Suppose we have an integer variable that stores the number of tweets that somebody has posted, cleverly called tweets. We could write out that value by saying you have plus tweets plus and then tweets with double quotes where you need them. That isn't really right, or at least it isn't beautiful, because what it should say is you have one tweet without an S or you have 10 tweets with an S. We need to be able to sometimes do one thing and sometimes do something else. The code that does this looks like this below. If tweets equals equals 1, notice two equal signs, not one, system out print line, you have 1 plus tweets plus tweet. Else, system out print line, you have plus tweets plus tweets with an S in it. The syntax for this is very simple. The keyword is if, then there's a Boolean condition, and there's an action that's taken if the condition is true. The else is optional, as are the curly braces, if you have only one thing in the statement, like we do in this case. But to tell you the truth, I put the curly braces in most of the time, because I think it makes the code easier to read. Let's look at another example. Let's let a user re-enter the number of items they purchased if they select a negative number. To do this, we'll create a scanner. Scanner input is new scanner system in. Then we'll create a variable to store the number they purchased, int purchase. We'll say purchase is input.nextint to let the user enter the number they've purchased. If purchase is less than 0, we'll do system out print line, please enter a positive number, and then purchase equals input.nextint. Notice this time the curly braces aren't optional because we have two things that we want to do when the statement is true, not just one. There's a problem though. Users can make more than one mistake. This code successfully corrects one mistake, but then lets the second one slip by. This could be tragic for a vendor because if a negative order is recorded, it might result in a refund. Definitely not what you want to be doing. And even if you catch this problem later, you're still not helping the customer order correctly, which is very important. There's a saying in programming that it's hard to make things foolproof because fools are so clever. To fix this, we need to know how to do things more than once. Repetition uses a Boolean condition, just like else does. The code looks like this, while, and then the Boolean condition in parentheses, and then curly braces that surround some actions. Just like if, the curly braces are unnecessary if there's only one statement. But with while loops, there's almost never only one statement, so just get used to putting the curly braces in. Here's the while loop that solves our problem. Scanner input is new scanner system in. Then we need to create a variable to store our purchase, int purchase. We need to get the number of purchases from the user, purchase equals input.nextint. And now we need a loop that will allow them to enter it repeatedly. So while purchase is less than 0, system out print line, please enter a positive number. And then purchase equals input.nextint. This loop will run as many times as the user makes mistakes, so we know when the loop is finished they've made a positive order. In summary, both if statements and while loops change the order in which program statements are executed. This is called flow of control in programming. Learning to use these statements strategically will make our programs shorter, prettier, easier to read, and more powerful.